Okay, good morning students, here I am. Okay, in previous lecture I was dealing with the properties of living beings, right? So now I'm going to deal with the definition of living being. As I've told you in earlier class or earlier lecture, that when you deal with the property of living beings as the growth, lifespan, reproduction, metabolism individually, then they are not defining a property, a great defining property for living beings. But now I'm going to, then what is living beings? How can we deal with the living beings? That is the first thing which comes is your definition. Who is a living being? Now when you deal with a living being is a self-replicating, evolving, self-regulating, interactive system capable of responding to their surrounding stimuli. What is living being? Living being is a self-replicating, evolving, self-regulating, interactive systems capable of responding to their surrounding stimuli. Now, when you talk about living beings, there is another thing. There are too many of living organisms all over the world. Now, I am going to deal with how to name what are these living organisms are and what is the biodiversity. Now, when you deal with the biodiversity, what is biodiversity? The large variety of living organisms, there are approx 1.7 to 1.8 millions are known to us, maybe more than that. How to describe the biodiversity? It is completely identification, naming and classification of an organism, right? How to name them, how to identify them, how to classify them. Classification of an organism is known as taxonomy. Naming an organism is known as nomenclating. Now, when you deal with the nomenclation, how to nomenclate? Nomenclating of an organism is in two ways. One is your common name, another one is your scientific name. Now, when you talk about the common name, what do you mean by common name? Common name is the name which is being used by the individual in a local area. Okay, there is no scientific formulas or scientific theories is being applied on these local names. Local name is being used for the people ease. Okay, it is easy to remember since childhood. Another thing, it is easy to pronounce. But when you talk about the drawbacks, they are not the standard name. They are not the standard name, so they mislead the people. They can mislead the people. So now, when you talk about the scientific names are the standard names and understood all over the world. It is across the world, you can understand this. They are being given in the Latin language. Latin language. What is this Latin language? Latin language is a dead language and generally used by all the scientists. Okay, now how to name an organism? When you talk about naming an organism, again, it contains three or four important points. Naming of an organism is known as nomenclature. Nomenclature can be binomial nomenclature, can be trinomial nomenclature, can be polynomial nomenclature. What is binomial nomenclature? Now, when you deal with the binomial nomenclature, listen here, students. Binomial nomenclature deals with the two names. It deals with the two names. Now, what are these two names? Two names are generic name. Two names are generic name and specific name. What are generic name and what are specific name? Now, when you talk about the generic name is also known as genus name. Specific name is also known as species name. Okay. Now, when you talk about genus name, okay, genus name is always these. There are some specific rules which are supposed to be followed for writing the binomial nomenclature. Now, what are those? Genus name can be written or genus name should be written in capital letter. For example, Magnifera indica. M-A-G-N-I-F-E-R-A. Magnifera indica. I-N-D-I-C-A indica. Now, see, student, when you deal with Magnifera indica, genus name is being written with capital letter M. Indica is written with the small letter I. Both the words are supposed to be underlined. They are supposed to be underlined separately. But when you are using in a printing form, then there is no need of underlining. You can use it in the italic way. The italic way. Clear? If it is being if the name is being written in italic form, then there is no need of underlining. But if you're writing with your hand, then it is must that you should underline both the words, genus name and species name, separately. Is it clear to everyone? Okay, thank you. Now, listen, students, I have told you about this thing. Then there are another two names. One is known as your by trinomial nomenclature and polynomial nomenclature. Now, when you talk about the trinomial nomenclature, deals with the three parts of the name Homo sapiens sapiens. As in binomial, we use the two names, for example, genus and species. Here you are using the three names Homo sapiens sapiens. Again, there is another term called polynomial nomenclature. Now, in the polynomial nomenclature where more than three names or more than three parts, the name of an organism is being utilized by more than three parts. Now, among all the three, the best suited or best accepted by the scientists is your binomial nomenclature, because it is easy to understand, it is easy to name, rather than using the trinomial or the polynomial nomenclature. Now, these names, naming of an organism, now rules for assigning the names. What are the rules? As I've told you about the binomial nomenclature, the rules and regulation which are supposed to be followed for writing the name of an organism is being given by the two places, that is ICBN and ICZN. ICBN is the International Code of Botanical Nomenclature, and ICZN is your International Code of Zoological Nomenclature. These are, name must not be changed. Now see, student, the name rules for assigning the name is given by these two, that is your International Code for Botanical Nomenclature and International Code for Zoological Nomenclature. These are the two important codes which are used for naming the flora and fauna. Okay, now father of taxonomy. What is taxonomy? Naming and arranging the organism is known as taxonomy. Taxonomy, taxus and names. Name nomies means laws.